The Earth is absolutely flat. My name is Dave. I'm known as Allegedly Dave. I'm 56 years old, and I know that the Earth is a flat, motionless plane. That is, the model is that there's a disk of water with continents strung out around the North Pole in the center, and it's bordered on the circumference with what we call Antarctica. Yeah, it's literally the circumference of the Earth. It's again, if you imagine the North Pole in the center, all the continents kind of strung out around the North Pole, and round the edge is what we call Antarctica. There's this thing called the Antarctica Treaty, which is a treaty by all the United Nations countries that have agreed that nobody is allowed to go there. You can go there on a package tour, and you'll go to the kind of outer islands, you know, see some penguins, go and see a barbershop pole that's supposed to be the South Pole, which they'll tell you isn't the actual South Pole. And that's it. If you want to go any further, or you want to go unaccompanied, you'll get turned back by the military. Well, I used to be a computer programmer, and I was so into science that I would listen to science lectures, while I was working. So I did a lot of research on Einstein's theory of relativity. I was listening to Richard Feynman lectures. I was into science. You know, I was just a normal bloke, just doing what everyone else does. But then you start seeing things that are wrong. And rather than just ignoring them, you know, thinking, oh, I must be stupid, I thought I'd actually look into them and see what I can find out about them. And once you do that, that's the turning point. Once you actually look, stop and look, put aside your preconceptions, then you find stuff. There's indoctrination right there. All these little kids looking at that, being told by their teacher, they live here. This is indoctrination. Yeah? At an age where they can't critically interpret information. This will form the basis of their reality. This is how easy it is. It really is. Even when NASA puts their stuff out that looks like this, they forget that the clouds are supposed to move. In fact, you find in the clouds they show in their pictures, they use a clone tool to use the same picture of cloud and stamp it around the globe. There's even the word sex written into the clouds somewhere, which is a known psychological trick to get you to engage with something. Every time I fly, I always take the time to speak to the pilots. And half the pilots I've spoken to have seen the curvature. Half the pilots haven't seen the curvature. According to mainstream science, nobody can see the curvature from a passenger jet.
I've looked at flight paths of things between South Africa and South America, and it's or Australia, and it's more so going over Antarctica. Well, they do. There are transantarctic flights. Oh. Not many, but it depends on the range of the aircraft.
Really, we've been trying to find. There's none. Nothing is allowed to fly over the South Pole.
Okay, so that comes down to ETOPS ratings in terms of how far an aircraft can go from an airfield. Such as the longest one is 330 minutes. That's the A350 or something. Which pretty much puts a hole over the Antarctica because it's so far away from every other airfield. Mm-hmm. They can't go over that because if they have a problem, it's too far away for somewhere to land. That way it comes back down to the ratings. But they can go often very near it.
Well, they say that, well, you know, it's too far to land in an emergency. The moon landing is absolutely fake. The supposed lunar lander. One good thing is that it's really accurate because there's no blast crater underneath the lander where there's a massive rocket engine, and there's no dust in the pads there. So, you know, very accurate indeed. But to think that this contraption made it to 238,000 miles away and landed on the moon is just ridiculous. Can somebody tell me how a zip holds back the vacuum of space? I don't know. How can you have zips in a spacesuit?
Because inside there's another rubberized suit that forms the secure lining. This is just protective.
Yeah.
Then you got another rubber one on the inside that's perfectly sealed.
How does rubber actually protect against radiation?
This outer suit does it.
The inner suit.
Yeah, no, but this is a suit behind a suit behind a suit. There's multiple layers. Each one has a different job. This one is for cooling.
Do you know how much shielding you need for radiation outside the Earth's atmosphere?
Oh, I don't know what it is, but...
But it's way more, it's like lead. You need lead shielding. No. Pretty much everything you see around you is not what it appears to be. It's just a story you were given, and if you believe it, well, you can live your whole life believing that story. But there's other things going on. But if you don't know about them, then you'll end up reacting to things that happen in this world. Think for yourselves, you know, rather than accept all this stuff that you've been taught. Think for yourselves.